sound effects!
For this tutorial, I'm going to show you everything you need to know about sound effects in hyperPad. When was the last time you played a game that had no sound effects? I don't know, I'm just curious. Auditory experience is one of the most influential part of everything. If your game has no sound,
it's already lacking!
No offense. It's like being deaf in a video game. And being deaf in real life is already bad enough. You don't hear an enemy walking behind you?
You dead.
You can't hear music in a rhythm game?
You dead.
Oh shoot, I was muted. Sorry. You don't hear me talking?
You dead.
You don't hear your dad for a while after he went to buy milk?
You dead.
Actually, he's probably gone. Sorry about your loss. But you get it. Your project needs audio.
No sound, no crown.
Facts.
That's the memo of this video.
Anyways, utilizing audio in your project is simple. You can either import your own or create your own audio effects with the built-in sound generator. So, let's go over everything you should know about sound effects. So first, let's try creating a sound effect. Navigate to your assets, then press create assets. You can see here, we can create particle and sound effects.
Whoa, cool.
If you want to learn how to create particle effects, the video is already published on the hyperPad YouTube channel. So go check it out after you watch this one. We want to create a sound effect for this case, so press sounds. You will be taken to the sound editor where a list of your sound effects will appear on the left. And in this area, you can configure and play your own sound effects. At the top, there are preset sound effects that you can use. Tapping on them will generate a sound effect based on that preset. So,
let's try them.
Notice that if I click on the same one, I will get a different sound effect. It generates a unique sound effect for that type, and as you can see, these sliders are changing each time. If you like what you hear, you can press this to play again. You can play it on loop, or save the sound effect to your project. Of course, you can adjust the final volume of the sound effect, and this cloud icon allows you to share the sound effect that you have saved. You can share it to other people, and they will get your sound effect as a GSND file?
I've never seen that file type in my life! What the frick is that?
What is that? Dang, 22 bytes?
That's extremely small.
That's what she said.
Your mom.
You're not funny. That's not what your mom
said. Oh my gosh, can you
calm down, guys!
Shut up!
Alright, we back. Let's talk sliders. And no, I'm not talking about the ones from White Castle. Ugh, those sliders are trash! Oh sure, I just started a whole war. Now, what these sliders do is affect how your sound effect will play out. Affect, effect.
Affect, effect. I need to learn how to pronounce those words.
Let's start basic. We have four sliders here, and all of them have to deal with the volume of the sound effect. There are three sections of a sound effect: attack, sustain, and delay. I know, it looked like a plot diagram. but let me explain. The attack time slider will determine how much time it takes for the sound volume to rise from the start until it reaches the sustain section. You can listen to the changes live. The further I move the slider, the longer this attack section will be. And of course, if you wanted it to sound more like a collectible, then you can turn the attack down all the way. See? The volume of the sustain section will stay constant. The sustain time slider determines how long this will be. And the sustain punch will determine how much louder the sustain section will be. You can make the sustain longer to make it sound like a siren, Or you can make the sustain short to make it sound more like a, I don't know, a notification sound effect. And of course, we have the delay section. It's just the part where the volume dies down until the sound effect is completely gone.
And you would know by now what the delay slider would do.
And cool, those are just the basics of creating sound in HyperPad. Now,
the advanced tab.
There is a lot to uncover. And I'll be honest, I'm not even sure what some of these sliders do. Is there a documentation somewhere? Hold up. What the freak? Hamid! Mataza! There isn't documentation on what what these sliders do. Oh well, most of these sliders probably won't matter, but I'll explain what the most important ones do. This determines what frequency your sound will start playing at. And by frequency, I mean pitch. It can start high, it can start low, it can start in between. Now, this one seems like it cuts off the sound effect at a frequency, so if it was set to be higher than the starting frequency, then the sound won't play at all. I don't know why this is a thing, but yeah, changing everything else doesn't seem to make a difference at all. Slide will change the pitch throughout the sound effect. You can make the pitch slide up, slide down, or just not slide at all and keep a steady pitch. All of these settings under it will affect how the slide will work. The low pass sliders will affect the low frequencies of the sound effect, so you can make it sound like it's underwater. The high pass sliders will affect the higher frequencies of the sound effect, so you can make it sound like it's playing from a speaker or from a radio. Now, the rest of these settings, I don't even know what they do. Just experiment with it and see what you like. Seriously, why don't these sliders have documentation? But that really doesn't matter much because we can import our own sound files into the project. After all, this sound maker is only capable of making retro-styled sound effects, which is perfect for retro games. So, what if you wanted to add in more realistic sound effects, like farts? Let's leave the sound editor. To import a sound effect, you go to the assets, and instead of pressing create effect, press import. HyperPad will give you plenty of options to choose from when it comes to importing stuff. And in this case, we want to import music and sound. Then you can go to your files and select the sound effect that you want. Once you selected your sound effect, it will be imported to your assets. And there it is! Oh, by the way, all the retro-styled sound effects that we have created earlier will be located in the sounds folder. How convenient. You can tap and hold on a sound effect and tap preview to play it. Oh gosh, why did I pick the nastiest sound effect for this? What the freak, man? Well, anyways, alright. Now I have some music, and I want to play it in the scene. You can select the audio and drag it into the scene like so. You can select it and adjust its parameters. So, I made it play music on loop at a low volume. Cool. Now, that's an easy way to implement music right there. But how do we trigger sound effects? In the behaviors of any object, you can select the play sound behavior. When the behavior is triggered, it will play a sound effect. You can adjust the pitch, volume, and panning. So let's say that when I start touching this dog, it will play a sound effect. There you go! That's how easy it is. Of course, you can do even more complicated things, but that's the gist of it. Now, let's talk about panning. The pan of the sound effect is how much the sound effect will play from the center. Negative numbers will go to the left, and positive numbers will go to the right. This is much more noticeable when you have stereo speakers or when you're wearing headphones, where you have a left side and a right side. You can use panning to your advantage to alert the player where something is. There's also some additional behaviors for audio. You can use gate music settings to get the current time, volume, duration, and see if the music is playing. You can pause and stop the music on command. Though the only limitation that you have here is that you can only have one music track playing at once. But that shouldn't be an issue if you're using the music feature as it is intended. And there's one more behavior for audio, and that's stop all sound effects. Self-explanatory, it stops all sound effects. Inside it, there's a toggle to trigger events. What this does is allow the play sound behaviors to execute behaviors under it when the sounds have been stopped. It's a very niche and technical feature, but it can be useful. Yeah, and that's everything you need to know about sound effects.
Cool.
Well, here's a trivial thing. Remember how you can place a sound effect in the scene like this?
No.
Well, you can actually summon it using spawn on object or spawn on area. When summoned, it will play a sound effect just like the play sound behavior.
What?
Well, you're better off using play sound.
But I thought that was interesting.
Now, that's everything there is to uncover about sound effects in hyperPad. If you liked the video, press that like button, and I will see you next time.
Bye!